I think it also arises from the sheer numbers, the sheer amount of B-boys and B-girls on Earth now compared to a much tinier number when I started dancing. You're only gonna have so many general categories of movement to work with.
Right.
Now, if you distribute those few categories over a few thousand people, you get a lot of opportunity for variation.
Right.
You distribute those few categories over several million people, you start to see a lot of the same thing over and over. And there's no way to know who has done what before you start doing it, because you're going to stumble upon something that has been done before until something new happens, but then it's a new thing, like bone breaking, for example.
Yeah.
And then it becomes another style with its own genre, music, etc., etc. But as long as we're breaking, we are automatically, inevitably going to head in the direction of dance sport. Like, you know, the individual differences become a lot more minimal, and you start thinking about how well people are doing the same things, which is what you see in dance sport, you know, what you see in ballroom dance, what you see in ballet, is what you see in ice skating, for example. But gymnastics, to really kick a dead horse, you know, we get compared to gymnasts a lot, but we're going to start looking more and more gymnastic, even without doing any gymnastics. We're still going to head in a gymnastic sort of direction where particular movements become required, and how well you do those movements becomes the basis upon which you give a score, a score.